Good there, ladies and gents. How's it going? This is a little bit different from my usual content, and it's mainly due to the lockdown that I am diversifying a little bit. But I understand that the majority of people who watch my videos watch them because I do motor vlogs, and because I've got a motor Guzzi and a dual sport or enduro bike and a Triumph. This isn't a Triumph. It's not even a motorbike. It's not even a toy car yet. It's a kit. It's a model. And I'm going to build this, but because I understand that the majority of you that watch my videos aren't into radio controlled cars, I didn't even know I was till lockdown really, I'm going to be putting these videos out on a Sunday, because I don't want to interfere in the stuff that you signed up for when you subscribe to my channel. It's going to be a short video series. I don't know how long it's going to take me to build this, but it's going to be fun and it will give me something to do, stop me getting into trouble and give me something constructive to do rather than sitting here playing computer games or just watching YouTube, which is really good. You should always just watch YouTube. Watch all of my videos. Those of you that are new to the channel because of this Hornet build, then welcome. Thank you for joining us. But please bear in mind that I'm not a radio control car fanatic and this isn't really an RC channel. But there will be the full build series of this, and there will also be some videos of me playing with it, no doubt, as well, depending on how much lockdown we have and how little time I get to actually ride my motorcycles, which is what I really, really like. So I hope any of you that watch this enjoy it, and I hope it provides you with a little bit of entertainment when you're bored, stuck at home, and stuff like that. So anyway, those of you that are here for the Hornet build, I hope you enjoy this. And if you haven't done so already, do click that subscribe button. It'd be awesome to have you come back for some more as the series progresses. And I'd love to have you enjoy my other content on here as well, if that's of interest. Right, let's get to it. Let's get this little Hornet built.
Keep that bike. Rubber side down.
Okay, so let's get into this. Let's get this build started. Now, I've already had a little bit of a look at all this, and here it tells you all the things that you need to buy for this build if you're going to do it in the same color schemes and stuff like that that Tamiya suggests, and it's got a list of all the paints there. Now, my paints haven't arrived yet, so I can't do any of those bits, but I have got them ordered and I am going to stick with the original color scheme as dictated here in the instruction of Rob's. I've ordered some paintbrushes, I've got my own basic tools and stuff like that, so I should be able to do all this up until the point of painting, but by the time we get to the point of painting, I'm hoping that those parts will have actually arrived. What we're going to do is do this stage by stage, and I am going to start with, I'm going to see how long it takes me to do bits. I'm quite happy with spanners and screwdrivers and all that sort of stuff. I'm kind of quite mechanically minded, but I don't know how long it's going to take me to do this. And I don't want to rush through it and get it all done in 10 minutes, not that it's going to take 10 minutes, and find I've got a half-assed build. So I'm going to work my way through each bit, and we'll split this off into sections that are sort of manageable for the viewers. Now, I don't know whether that will be 15-minute videos or what. We'll have to see, but we'll play it by ear and hopefully we'll get a few videos out of this and you'll find it enjoyable to watch. First of all, I believe we are doing the gearbox, so I need to find the parts of the gearbox within the instruction of a Bob's, and we can get this underway, get it on the go. Now, the kit comes with these nylon bushings, and I have been told by a friend that they wear out very quickly, and I've got myself some metal ball bearings for all races. So where it tells me to put these in, I'm going to be putting these in. Yeah, it makes sense to do it now, because doing it later on is going to be a pain in the neck because I have to strip it all down. So yeah, cool. Okay, so we want one of these and one of these. I need to put that under there, and that slots into place there, nice and easy. Okay, now this needs some grease on it. The grease kindly exploded when I opened it. So we've got a sheath, which goes there, and a bearing, which goes there, and looks like we have another bearing which goes on the other side of it. once it's in the gearbox. Okay. So that's that bit. Okay. And this appears to go in there. That goes on there. I can sort of grease this and a bearing. And that goes in there. And then we want another bearing on this side. And the same on this one as well. Yep. So we've got these ones, which is this and this and this. Each of these has one of them, and one of them, and one of them. Then I need to grease all of that up. Right. They slot into this. I like that. Okay. Okay, so that's in there like that. Now what I need to do is get this, which I think goes on this one. That goes in there, and this goes in here. That's a self-tapping screw, that is. I'm just going to give my hands a wipe because they're going to slip on the screwdriver. Okay, so if I put this down there like that, and it's a Phillips, and hopefully this will fit. That's a bit small. Let's use this one. This is a self-tapping screw, so I don't want to over-tighten it. Right, so this is everything on here done, I believe. And then that goes in here. And then we need to grease this. That's almost all of the grease used up, and we haven't even finished stage two. Anyway, so this goes onto there. I like that. Goes into there. Hold it all together. Okay. Now again, don't want to over tighten these, so I'm just going to go gently with them to start with. I have to say, doing this with the camera is really kind of adds an extra layer of complicated. I'm going to have to wipe my hands again in a second because they're all greasy and they're slipping on the screwdriver. So they're all in. I just need to now nip them up so that they are all nice and tight together. This one's an arse. It's weird how some of them go in really easily and others less so. But that is the gearbox together. What I'm going to do now is attach the motor and then we'll call this video here until the following week. Like that. Okay. Okay, so this one goes on this side, like so, and then this goes in there, and this does up. Oh, okay, I can't do it. There we go. So we've got the motor, and we've got the gear. That goes. There, like that, and there's the flat bit, and the grub screw goes into the flat bit. So I'm just going to get this grub screw started. Okay, this Allen key comes with the kit, which is quite nice. That's on there, and goes onto there. Let's just get it started. And then this goes on that way around there. Okay, so to do a quick battery swap, the battery expired on me. It expired. According to the instructions up here, I need a 16 millimeter gap between the motor and the end of that. So I need to measure that. So I'm just gonna go and find myself a ruler. Okay, so I got myself a ruler. 16 millimeter. Oh, just put that so it's got a little bit of friction on it, so it's not wobbling around quite so much. There we go. I'd say that's actually pretty close to cock on. 16 mil. That was a good little guess. Just tweak that up so it's tight and check it again. That's the trouble is the motor moves and actually that's less, so I need to tweak it a little bit. What we got now? I'd say that's around 16. The thing is, it moves in and out around a millimetre, so I don't know whether that's correct or not, but that's good enough for the moment, and we can always adjust it later. Just want to tighten that up, or at least check that it's tight. Don't want that coming undone. They're so tight with the amount of grease they give you. It is really, really bad. I've got this and that and that. There's Tammy have written that around, so that wants to go that way up. Okay. Which means this needs to go that way around, because you only got three holes on it and we need it vertical. Okay, let's see if we can see what we're doing. Not very easily, I'm afraid. So that's grabbed it. Now I just need to do the bottom one and then tighten them up. Cool. Okay. Now give them a little nip. One of my friends told me I should be Loctite in all these. I don't really want to Loctite it all down on first assembly and find I've done it wrong. Okay, so that is that. That's the gearbox and motor assembled. I think that's a plenty long enough video for you guys for the moment. I do hope you have enjoyed this so far, and you enjoy the rest of this season of building this Tamiya Hornet. It's giving me something to do, keeping me out of trouble. And like I say, for those of you that are only really interested in the bike content, feel free to not watch any of these. I'm just doing this because some of the people on my Facebook page told me they wanted me to do this. And those of you that are interested in this build purely for this, and you're not into the bike stuff, I hope you're enjoying this and it's not too amateurish in how I am, one, making a video, and two, putting this thing together. If you do have any suggestions, if you do think that I should be Loctiting everything up, then do tell me. These videos are going to be going up possibly not as I do them, so I might well have been at a different stage by the time you've made those comments. So yeah, please bear that in mind. I will be ahead of the game by the time I get to see your content, see your comments and stuff. So yeah, anyhow, like I say, I hope you enjoyed this. If you haven't done so already, please click that subscribe button. It'd be great to have you come back for some more, especially if you're interested in this build. And if you like this, give it a little thumbs up, and if you didn't, you can always give it a little thumbs down. That's all cool. It's all cool in the school. We don't mind. We don't care. But whatever you do, please do drop in a comment. I love hearing from you. And yeah, I'd say I'd close out my normal way, but I can't because this isn't bikes. So play safe. Take care. And I shall catch you all in the next one. Bye-bye for now.
Keep that bike. Rubber side down. Hey, no, you gotta keep that bike. Rubber side down.